we got here just in time. And Jose, so how long has the pigs been on the fire? You said about 4 hours?
Exactly 4 hours.
Yeah.
Put them inside the box, butterfly, square eagle face up for 3 hours.
Yeah.
And at the 3 hour mark, you flip it over onto its belly, and that will be nice and crunchy.
Yeah. Try to talk over him, but I'm just gonna shoot. I'm gonna watch you in action, and later on, maybe we can talk about the China box. Did you marinate the pig?
Yes, with Cuban style, with olive oil all over the body, crushed garlic, and Goya adobo.
Goya adobo seasoning. Well, look at that. That's beautiful. You put it on the rack, so it makes it easy to handle.
Exactly.
How many of these have you done in your career here?
I've probably done
100. 100? Wow.
And we record all the parties on the side of the box, so every celebration is recorded.
Always good. And then you put some charcoal on the top of that china box, and it crisps the skin up beautifully.
Absolutely.
Wow. Pictures while it's pretty.
Yeah, and what we're gonna do now is we're gonna carve off the skin because everybody likes the crunchy skin, and that'll allow the pig to put it on a little so I can then carve them off.
Yeah.
So we'll start right here.
What do they call that? Chicharrones?
Chicharron.
Chicharron.
Yep.
Oh man.
You get the first piece.
Oh, thank you, sir. Oh man. I came hungry too.
I'll get you now. Let me send you.
Thank you.
I'll get you another piece.
Wow.
That's got some nice. It's hot. It's hot.
Look at that.
Life is short. Eat all the things you're not supposed to.
No, once in a while.
Anybody? Anybody? Hot, crunchy.
Do something, Dan.
Minnesota. A beautiful farm. got there? A leg?
This is a rear leg.
Rear leg. And
most people know this as a ham.
Yeah.
When it's roasted, it's totally, you can see how sucking it is. This falls off. Falls off the wall. See how sucking it that meat is.
A lot of meat. I mean, you were telling me last year that a pig has got more meat per bone ratio than pretty much any other animal.
You can eat everything on a pig, from the nose to the tail.
Nose to the tail.
Including the intestines and the blood.
China kind of roasted and like steams it at the same time, huh?
And she's still out traveling with business.
It doesn't look so great.
This guy coming in.
Grass has a lot of grass.
Looks like a golfer to me.
What's up,
huh?
Think it's gonna rain?
I need to find out myself. I'm kind of thirsty. Jose, good to see you, man. It's been I can't believe a whole year has gone by already.
Well, it's good to be back with the Abraham family. This is year number 7, and hopefully we'll be here again next year.
Year number 7, you've been doing this for us, huh?
Well, this is 7
for
years
Jim,
now.
For your good friend, Jim Ingraham.
Absolutely.
Uncle Jimmy's son. Nothing like good friends and family, right?
That's right.
That's what it's all about.
Nothing.
The United States of America, the free United States.
That's right, that's right.
Nothing better than friends and family, except
maybe
a sucking pig. Right?
That's right.
How you doing?
That's Emil.
Yeah, Emil? What do you think of this rain? Cool it down a little bit, huh? Going out to water the garden. Okay.
This is your tenderloin.
Wow.
It comes off and it just melts.
Look how tender that is.
Breaks right up.
Unbelievable.
Thank you so much.
Look at that. First plate of the night. All right, what's your name, sir?
Joe Goffler.
Joe, how you doing?
Good. I'm
doing I remember
dandy.
You from last year.
This is my wife, Jill.
Jill? How are you? Getting some of Jose's beautiful Cuban-style pork, right?
Oh, wow. Yeah. That's perfect. That's perfect.
This is right off the rib. Look at this. This is like butter.
Oh, yeah.
Get yourself a plate. It's like butter.
Ooh. Wow.
You must be special because he doesn't just give that to anybody. Right, Jose?
That's right.
What I like about Jose, he doesn't waste anything.
Oh, yeah, nothing.
I just saw him gnawing. He cleaned everything off a bone, and he was nibbling off of that bone. He's got a lot of respect for what that does.
That's the best tasting meat, right next to the bone.
You know it.
It's delicious.
I like to make stock out of those bones, Jose. Make a sauce out of them.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. And some people use the head.
Yeah.
And they make a nice soup.
Yeah, they got a lot of gelatin in the head and the bones.
Gelatin. There's some good meat in the cheeks.
Yeah.
And the tongue is actually very tasty.
I worked with a German chef, and we made a lot of the veal stock, you know. Like the most people make it out of veal.
Yep.
We do it out of veal and pork.
Mm-hmm.
Tremendous. And I don't know why. Pork bones, they like, I think because people boil them too hard and they make soap out of pork bones and stuff.
Yeah.
But to me, pork's got more flavor than beef.
I think so too, and especially when you cook the entire animal.
Yeah.
You like dark meat?
Looks like he knows what he likes right there, huh?
We're hoping to do the same thing.
Look at that.
We're not sure.
Let's grab this plenty more.
Whether we're going to get to do it or not.
Come back and get as much as you want.
Right after Christmas.
It must have been a learning process for them. For the big one.
Did you open a restaurant?
Huh?
Chicken soup? Yes.
Did you open a restaurant?
They grilled the same.
I'm opening one.
Oh, you are?
Yeah.
You told us last year.
Hey, Jack.
Getting some wisdom from the elders.
This is for posterity.
You're getting
posterity.
Some. You're garnering some wisdom from the senior member of the clan.
I hope that thing doesn't have audio on it. Yeah, I put us in trouble.
Yeah, right. Good beer.
Hey, the names have been changed to protect the guilty.
Yeah.
Right.
Beer.
Alright, we worked our way up from the tail section. You up by the shoulder, by the neck.
Yeah.
Wow.
A lot of nice meat there.
Man, oh man.
Yeah. Very hot.
How much a pound you gotta pay for a pig these days?
Pig of this size you're getting for about $260 a pound.
What size you got?
This one was a 65 pound.
65. Well, how many pounds of meat do you think you get off it?
Probably, there's a real good meat to bone ratio, so you probably end up getting, you can see these are the only bones that are left over in the box here.
Wow.
So you're probably looking at about 10 pounds of bone and 55 pounds of meat.
How many pounds of meat?
Probably 55 pounds, because it's a very efficient animal. Very, very high meat to bone ratio on a pig.
Look at that pig's foot. I think I'm going to have to try that out.
Yeah, that's a delicacy. You're going to take one of those.
Yeah, I never ate one of those. I'm going to have to try that out.
Very good.
You see those pickled things.
Yeah, you have a nice cold beer and a pig's foot.
Yep.
And just enjoy it.
Man, oh man.
A lot of meat.
Well, look at all the people we fed off of that one pig. All these people are eating off of that pig and he's still got a ton left.
There's still plenty of meat left in my head because I'll take the cheeks and the jowls. There's a lot of meat right there.
Yeah. You've been going nonstop, Jose. That humidity's not bothering you?
Nah.
Huh?
It's a little hot, but
just replenish with some of that cold beer, you'll be all right.
I have to keep refueling, that's all.
Look at that, man. Woo!
Thank you, sir.
We got some of the upper ribs.
Upper ribs. So there's still a lot of meat there. You can see a lot of the infused garlic.
Yeah.
You know, people can chew on that. Nice little rib bone. Yeah. Get some of the meat off of that.
A good knife, that does a lot of the work for you.
Yeah, this knife
got some weight behind it.
It's 60 years old and it's never been sharpened. It's a nice German steel and it stays sharp.
Never been sharpened?
Never been sharpened all the time I've owned it.
Would you just put a steel on it?
It just keeps an edge. It's a real quality knife.
Carbon steel.
Yeah.
Look at that, man. A ton of meat up by the head. All right, we're here with Jim, and I was noticing, I seen him nibbling the corn. Jim cooked the corn, and move that cup out of the way, Jim. We don't want to send the wrong impression.
Serving.
Wow.
Oh, I don't
but
think so.
I just,
I my second.
I just noticed Jim.
I'm on four myself. You're on four. So I'm behind you.
I noticed you saved plenty of room for dessert.
The desserts are excellent.
What'd you get, a little
Nobody
pie?
Nobody knows better than
I
you.
Have some pie, what do you call this? You call this bark or something. Bark.
It's a bark.
Bark, yeah. Oh, man, I like that.
Some lemon. Some lemon, lemon pie.
You have to cook like this for the
pie? Yeah, right.
Listen to him.
Right. Well, she's been actually doing very good. She has this magazine, Cuisine Magazine.
Oh, I saw it. That is excellent.
And
yeah.
She has been doing
which is
all these special little dinners, and every one of them has been excellent.
You're the beneficiary of it.
Yeah, I'm the beneficiary.
You probably bought her the subscription to it too, didn't you?
I don't know who did that. I think your mother did, right? Your mother? She's trying to fatten me up.
I took the prescriptions because my brother cooked.
All right, Jim, good job on the corn as usual, huh?
Thank you.
That was awesome. Hi, right, y'all. What's this, the 7th annual?
Oh,
I think it's the 7th one.
2003 by that box.
Yep. 7th one, I believe.
7th one, pig roast, annual pig roast. James Ingraham House up in Acton, Massachusetts.
A little damp this year, but yeah,
you know what? Suck it up.
Every year it gets better.
The tunes, you had to
listen. I know.
It came with a New Orleans band. That's why they got, you know, they brought it with that once they booked that band. Yep. They were good.
Excellent.
Hey, take care.
Bye
bye now.
Take it easy. Now you're good.
Money's in the bag.
Huh?
The money's in the bag.
Where's the heavy stuff?
Heavy is under my belt.
We need the combination to that lockbox.
Lockbox?
Yeah.